Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with a short information about my different plugins. I did update the whole page to version TillyWiki version 5.1.19, and now I want to show you the new behavior of the Unilink plugin. So open the page. Unilink has two things. There is the alias handling and Unilink handling. And with, let's say, default tiller links, the old version either used the title or the caption or the subtitle. If the subtitle was there, then the subtitle wins. Now this behavior changed. So we have a global setting now, which is part of the control panel. So you can see it, control panel, Unilink. There you can define it. The default is the title. So it's the same behavior as a standard TillyWiki. But now you have the possibility to globally change it. So we can say, okay, I want to have the caption, if there is one. If there is no caption, then it shows the title. So I open this tiller. This is this one. Okay. And you can see it has a caption and a subtitle. Okay, now I can say, okay, I want to use the caption or the title, or I want to use the subtitle. So now it says subtitle and subtitle here. So this short title tiller has no caption, it only has a subtitle. So title and caption is the same. If I open it, then you can see it only has a subtitle. Why did I do this? Because the alias plugin or the alias handling got a new functionality. And it also turns out that subtitle wins was not a good setting. So now we have a global setting, so you can define it globally and that's it. For the alias handling, you know already, there you can create the tiller and define several aliases. So this tiller has four of them. So it's Darwinism, Neo-Darwinism, Natural Selection, and Theory of Evolution. And all these aliases can be used to link to the same tiller, as you can see here. The important thing is that this name here is not case sensitive. So the aliases are not case sensitive, and the link is always shown like this. So this gives you the freedom that at the start of a sentence you can start with a capital letter, or in the flow you can use lower letters. So you can basically do whatever you want. The new thing with the alias handling is there is a new shortcut. So if you have question mark T, it uses the title, always uses the title. Question mark C uses the caption as a title, as a link title. Question mark S is the subtitle field, and question mark field name uses the text in the field name. So if I open it again, there is a field called my field, and it uses the text which is shown here. This is free, so you can use any title, any field name if you want. So you could also write question mark title or question mark caption. But T, C, and S is a shortcut, and it's more convenient. So that's basically the new functionality of the alias. What else is there? In edit mode, you already know, if you write something and you select it, there is the aliasify button with Control K. So it creates an alias. Alias link like this. Remove the space. Or now there is a new button. I have to search for a different icon. Or control space. It gives you a dialog. If you say space, you get all the available aliases. And I can say, okay, I want to have Alexander the Great as an alias link. So it inserts Alexander the Great. Or you can create a new one. Test and say enter, Ja, then it enters test alias link. Ja. Or you can say, okay, write something, control space, opens this search space again. Ja. So this is a new functionality of the which comes with Unilink plugin. What else is there? We have more than there is the aliases tab. There you have the different aliases which are defined, and below you can see the titler name. There is sorting by title, yeah, so this is the title, and there are the different aliases which are defined, and so on. And then there is undefined. This is important. Undefined detection can only be done if you reload the page. Yeah? There is no better way at the moment, so we'll see in the future. Okay. So more aliases. Yeah? What else do we have? That's basically it. Yeah? The new function with the edit toolbar or control space, which everything is there. So if you have the keyboard shortcuts, there you can see them. There is the aliasify, control K and control space, which is the default setting at the moment. Yeah? You can redefine it with the default settings from TillWiki. Yeah, the other thing that I said already is the default link handling, which has a global setting now, which is different to the old version of the plugin. Yeah, that's basically it. How can you install it? You open the control panel and say plugins, and can drag and drop the plugin from here. Yeah, that's it. I hope you have fun with the new functionality, especially the alias handling, the new one. Yeah, have fun and see you later.